I'm Linda Miller, the curator of the Maximus Gallery here at the Santa Barbara Museum of Natural History. The Art of Natural History features selections from the museum's unique collection of antique prints relating to the history of scientific research and exploration. Many were made during an era in which the world's flora and fauna were being described for the first time. Because images captured nature in ways that complemented written descriptions, a visual record became an essential element of this process. These detailed illustrations were published in significant numbers so that others could share information. By the 18th century, so much had been discovered, there was a great need to bring order to all this chaos. A classification system introduced by the Swedish botanist Carl Linnaeus came into use by which all living organisms could be grouped, ordered, and named. In time, two trends of natural history art developed. Plants were drawn with all their form and color, but also with their reproductive parts displayed and magnified. Although the Linnaean style of art came to dominate, an ecological style also emerged, in which relationships in nature were pictured. Mark Catesby, in his great book on the natural history of early colonial America, was one of the first to show the interactions of living things. A 100 years later, John James Audubon painted his Birds of America in their fully developed natural habitats. As more skilled artists became involved over the years, what began as a fundamental aid to scientific inquiry became prized works in themselves, and were sought after for their intrinsic beauty, a blend of art and science. At first, these works on paper were produced by printing images from copperplate engravings. But by the mid-19th century, lithography had become the primary means of reproducing images in multiples. Examples of both these techniques are on display in the gallery. These highlights are drawn from our own large collection of antique prints. They give us a glimpse of history and how the sciences developed. Museum collections are libraries of the world's biological, cultural, and environmental history, and are vital to our ability to interpret the past and understand our place in its future. Today, scientists here at the museum care for extensive natural history collections of more than 3 million objects used for research by our curatorial staff as well as visiting scientists from around the world. These specimens provide valuable data and serve as a vast archive for ongoing investigations. The expertise of the museum's scientific staff underpins and supports all of our educational efforts.